And that was a badly needed Bob Marley for the whole world here, and we all could use just a little bit more love, that's for sure, especially in these times these days. So anyway, we have Dan Sindel is on the phone this morning, and Dan has just finished his 5-song EP. I'm so excited. Some of it we have already played. We've had Dan on a few times on the show, but he was not quite finished with all the songs, so some of them I haven't even heard yet. I'm pretty excited to get to listen to those. But hold on 1 second while I bring Dan on the line here. All righty, let's see. Where is Dan? Mr. Dan, are you there?
Hello, Joe. Hello, world. Hello, Morro Bay, Central Coast.
Welcome to Radio Land, Dan. All right.
Hey.
So we have had you on the show few times recently, and we had a very special show just a couple weeks ago for a tribute to your friend who's playing drums on one of these songs. I know we're going to talk a little bit about that again, but yeah. We've got some exciting news. We're going to offer up a one of your EPs today. I hear we're going to be able to have a listener call in and win it, so we can send them the download. That's going to be really cool. So stick around at the end of the let's see, we're going to do it on the second song, I think we said. So second song, you can call in. First person to call in will win the 5-song CD. Dan's going to send it out to you personally. Pretty cool stuff there. But why don't we start off with well, tell us a little bit about yourself, Dan, for those who don't know Mr. Dan Sindel. Tell us a little bit about yourself and your musical career.
Well, first of all, good morning, Joe. Good morning, everybody. Hope you're peppered with your coffee out there. I'm just waking up, so here we are. Yeah, I'm just grateful to be here. For any of you that don't know, I live down here in L.A. in the Valley area, and I went to high school with Joe, so I've known him like 100 years.
Yeah, at least.
And we're still friends. Music keeps us together, and it's just an awesome thing. I'm still playing guitar. I never quit, and I just finished putting together a brand-new 5-song EP. And, you know, over the past few months, I've visited the show sort of, you know, part by part, playing songs as they were released because I was excited and Joe was nice enough to play them. But now I have an official collection, finished, mastered, and I'm going to figure out what to do as far as pressing CDs and vinyl LPs. And, yeah, I'm just really happy to be here and share this brand new music with you guys. And I just hope you really enjoy it because I sure worked my tail off to bring it to a place to where it's, I guess you could call it, competitive product.
Yes, nice. Well, you left out that you are actually giving back to the musical world there. Dan is actually a guitar teacher at a local college in the L.A. area. So if you happen to be in the L.A. area and looking to take some guitar lessons, look up your local college. It's pretty cool stuff there. You have some great lessons. I see you sharing them occasionally on Facebook. It's pretty cool. And you know what was really cool? What I thought was really cool, I wanted to revisit this. There were a lot of companies that, when they heard what you were doing with the kids and the colleges, they really reached out to you and provided some equipment and things and just really made that whole thing so amazing that everybody was giving back. And some of the strings, and I think you gave away some tuners and stuff. That was really cool. You know, people are reaching out and backing you up there, Dan. I dig it. It's awesome.
Well, since you bring that up, if you know the San Fernando Valley area, anyone, I teach at Los Angeles Pierce College, and I also teach at Los Angeles Valley College. And what you're referring to is, in the music realm, I've visited the NAMM show a lot in Anaheim, and I've shared what I've got with a lot of the companies, and a lot of the musical companies, you know, the big names, the same guys that put all their products into Guitar Center and every place, they really like what I do. And one person in particular I really need to give a shout out, his name is Ben Cole. Amazing friend. He works for D'Addario. They make strings and Planet Waves. They make all these crazy awesome accessories for guitar players. And he's been sponsoring my class to where I can give the students a really nice expensive guitar tuner, a fresh pair of strings, and, you know, some string winder gizmos. I feel like Santa Claus when I'm able to give this stuff out. It's really cool. So, yeah, I'm really happy to be able to continue myself with music and be able to pass the torch and foster education as well. It's a good thing. Thanks, Joe.
Yes, it actually is, and that's why I felt it was worth mentioning, for sure. Neat the way you give back. It's good stuff. All right, well, Dan, tell us a little bit about the first song that we're going to play. So what's the name of the song, and give us a little background on how it came about.
Okay.
I'll make it rough on you, huh?
Yeah, everything's, you know, kind of a...
Should I wait for the second cup of coffee for the really...
No, we're good, man. The first one was strong.
Yeah.
Well, to get started, friends, my album is called Unpopular Music for Popular People. Which in of itself is a very cynical and sarcastic title, but what can you do? Nothing's left in the music world except for cynicism and sarcasm. Everything else has been taken. all routines and shticks, as they say, gimmicks have been taken, so I'm just relying on sarcastic wit.
You have lots of that.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of a funny, weird time for the music industry at large. CD sales have all but disappeared. You can't even buy a computer with a compact disc player anymore. What happened? Everything is now downloads and streams. It's just a tough time for musicians. So I'm thinking to myself, after all these years, this is a fine time to finally cross the finish line with a CD with some of my music. But, you know, you just got to do it. You know, what are you going to do? So, you know, at least I have a chance to play it for you guys on the radio today. And the very first song is called All Due Respect. It's a beautiful love song, a soliloquy of poetic justice. And this features my good friend, John Ayala. Hey, Johnny, there's your shout-out, dude. Party!
Cool.
And it's like a, it's a kind of a 2 minutes sort of a slamming type of a power pop, kind of a hard rock song. I don't know how you classify music. Maybe we can talk about that later, how impossible it is to actually label music these days.
Right.
It's not simple. Anyways, this is a rocking tune, guys. I hope you like it.
All right. Well, we are going to play the very, very first song on the EP. We're ready to go. All right, Dan, thanks. Hang in there, buddy. We'll be right back after the song.
I'll be direct, need to correct what's not perfect. How to correct things I suspect, cannot neglect clues I reject. With all due respect, with all due, yours is yours, mine is mine. How could you dare to cross that line? Tables are turned out in my favor. With all due respect, victory I savor. Yes. heart's not perfect. How to comment things I suspect. Cannot neglect clues I detect. With all due respect. With all due respect. With all due respect. You'll never have respect. With all due respect. With all due respect. With all due respect. You'll never have respect.
And that was called All Due Respect by Dan Sindel. Wow. Dan, you there, right?
Yeah, rock
and roll. Oh, my gosh. Dude, that one is one of the ones I have not heard. That is amazing. The lead in the background is just going off.
That's cool. That's a good one, huh?
You know, I wanted to, something just popped into my head that I wanted to mention real quickly. You posted something on Facebook. You were playing a Jimi Hendrix song with a band. I don't know. It was one of those, you know, flashback memory things or something. And right. You know what? While I was watching it, I was watching you just shred this Jimi Hendrix lead. And you look like you're barely even playing the guitar. It's just, you stand there like all this is so effortless, and yet you're just ripping it. It's just crazy how your fingers are going so fast, but you don't even, you know, it doesn't even look like, you know, it's a challenge for you. It's like, oh my gosh, you truly are an amazing guitarist. So tell us a little bit about who was on this one. Is it mostly you? And then you gave a shout-out to John Ayala. So is he part of the recording or help with it? Or?
You're talking about this song, All Due Respect?
Yes.
Basically, throughout the whole album, actually, everything is me. I'm playing all guitar. I'm playing all the bass. I'm doing all the vocals. And the only thing that changes from song to song is I hire different drummers to play on the song for me. You know, I wrote the songs at home using, you know, pre-recorded drum software loops.
Right.
So I was able to have something to work with, and then I bring those into the studio and I hire awesome friends in the LA area, and they replace the computer stuff with real human drums. It's awesome.
Well, there you go. AI at its best, but removing it to the human part, which is good. I like that.
Absolutely.
So was it? What did who played drums on this one?
All Due Respect. That was John Ayala.
That was him. Okay.
My homie.
That's right.
My brother from another mother.
Yeah. What? He was in another band, right? Was that Odin? No.
No. John came up in the 80s in a band called Lakes. And,
oh. Okay.
You know, that was. You know, they all came from that. You know, the East LA, South Pasadena, Alhambra area. You know, Lace was, you know, friends growing up with Arnold Singh and all those guys.
Right, yeah, I figured. Okay.
And then me and John played for a little while in MX Machine with Diego.
Oh, really? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Now I remember that. I remember MX Machine. That was a good band.
Yeah, kick-ass, hardcore kind of punk metal, huh?
Yeah, right? The 80s, Dan, the 80s. Oh, my gosh. Going back. So many stories. Wow. We truly have partied like rock stars with rock stars. It's pretty crazy.
Hey, but we anyway, are rock stars without being stars.
Yeah, exactly. Well, everybody's a star in their own mind, right? So we're going to move on to the... Well, I think, you know, if we going back to the 80s, I mean, we obviously got to mention Stone Soldier. You guys were just so unbelievable. So many big bands at that time were coming out to see your shows. You know, I mean, I can remember Dave Mustaine and Ozzy came one time with Mike at the gosh, what was that one in North Hollywood called? I can't remember the name of that one. They tore it down. FM station?
Oh, FM station.
Yeah, that one. So, you know, you had a lot of heavy hitter people in the music business coming out to see you guys back in the day. And that was really the beginning of the Dan Sindel era, huh? Anyway, so let's move on to your second song. Tell us a little bit about it, and who's playing drums on this one? Is it John again?
No. This next song, song number two, is called Say Goodbye. And this features my dear friend Alex Wyatt, who just recently passed away a few months ago, who we talked about last time I was on the program.
Right.
Now, this is one that your audience has never heard. So the first two tracks on my album are my two freshest, newest, hottest tracks.
Hottest.
And, oh yeah. This is a 6-minute sort of a progressive metal sort of thing. I don't know how you describe music. I don't know. But it's a 6-minute epic. And yeah, it's a kind of a thematic event. Just, I was watching local news one day and sort of a quote unquote human interest story was going on, and I decided to use that as the basis of the song here. It's a little bit early. We'll keep things not too dark and gloomy for your audience. But yeah, life itself isn't always on the sunny side. There's, you know, there's always a lot of grim reality out there. I've been watching The Sopranos, and they sure show a lot of bad things.
Okay. Well, all you need to do is flip on the news for that anymore, and you get plenty of bad.
I know.
Crazy,
it's
crazy
the most
stuff.
Depressing. Yes. Local news anywhere is just depressing.
Yeah.
But you know what? I think that's why we hide in our music, because music is positive and uplifting and takes you out of the realm of things that are troubling you. And that's the way I create music, because it helps me channel things that, you know, it's like therapy. I think most musicians will sort of say that music is therapy for them, and hopefully someone along the way resonates with what you do.
Right.
And, yeah, so this song is called Say Goodbye. It features Alex. And did you want to do that radio thing with your audience now?
Yeah, why don't we, if you want, this is a 6-minute song. So let's see if somebody wants to call in and win one of your EPs. So I'm going to have to hang up with you, and you can call me back in 6 minutes when the song's over. And we'll see if anybody calls in to win the CD.
Yeah, I'll say this real quick.
Sure.
Before I called up everybody who's listening, I was asking Joe, because they have coming up this Saturday, that big event, the fundraising concert, and I really wanted to be part of it, but I'm not feeling too well. I'm kind of battling a cold flu thing, so I had to kind of cancel coming up north. You know, it's a 3-hour drive for me to get there, and you know, I'm just still not feeling 100%. But I wanted to still participate with the event, and I was asking Joe if there's a way, while one of the songs are playing, to do one of those call-in things where somebody out there can call into the radio station. Joe will give you the number before the song plays, but I would personally love to donate a free download to the very first caller.
All right. Well, our number here is 805-772-2037. 805-772-2037. Call in and win one of Dan's 5-song EPs. What an amazing gift that would be. All right.
Call in now, but not. But wait, there's more.
There's more.
Free gifts through life.
And wait, for only $42 more a month. Okay, we can add in this really soft pillow. Anyway, all right, Dan. So we got it. 5-song EP, first caller in. 805-772-2037. The name of the song we're playing again, Dan?
Is Say Goodbye, and first caller wins.
Say Goodbye. All right. Say Goodbye by Dan Sindel. Here we go.
Say goodbye.
Listening to the Local Joe Show here on 97.3, 107.9 The Rock, and we are speaking with Dan Sindel. Dan, that was amazing. Wow. You there?
Yes, oh. You are listening to 97.3, 107.3 The Rock, Central Coast, California.
Oh, gotta love it. You're gonna steal my job, huh? I like it.
All right. Yeah, I can work
remote,
buddy.
So, I got a little bit of, you know what, you're right. I don't know how you would put a genre to what you're doing. It's crazy because the beginning of the song almost reminds me a little bit of some B-52s, and then there's just so many changes in it. It's crazy. So I don't know how you would label any of this, but wow, that was very impressed. That's amazing. He was He had some great fills in there. The drummer was amazing. This was your friend Alex that passed recently?
Yeah. Boy, Alex sure knocked it out of the park on that one. That was a really tough recording session because it's a tricky song. There's so many different parts, and we just worked through it part by part, brick by brick, and God bless him, you know?
Wow. Well, his legacy lives on through your song. It's amazing. It's good stuff.
And the beautiful thing is the song itself had been mixed by my dear friend Steve Sykes, who is a multi-platinum mixing engineer. He's worked with everybody in the industry. I'm talking, well, he told me he's worked with, like, Sting and the guys from Toto and Rod Stewart. I mean, just everyone you can even imagine he's worked with. And yet he's kind enough to help me in my endeavors. You know, I'm not a big major label signed recording artist, but, you know, based on our friendship, he helps me along because he likes what I'm doing. And I'm grateful, very grateful.
Wow. Well, that's what it all takes to put everything together like this is. And, you know, it's amazing all the people that some of these people have worked with. When I was on tour with Michael Schenker, the bass player would come down to the T-shirt booth, and he liked to hang around on the other side of the fence, you know, sort of set, you know. And it would be amazing how often he would sit in the booth, and nobody would even know who he was, even though the funny thing is his picture was on, really big on one of the T-shirts that was right there, but, you know, it doesn't make much sense. But people would come up and ask him, you know, hey, do you got any double extra large? And I'm like, oh, no, he doesn't work in the booth. And no, so many people didn't even know who he was. But the cool thing was, it was funny, the few people that would recognize him, one of the biggest questions he would get is, you know, who all he's played with. And, well, oh, my God, one day he put it on Facebook, a list of everyone he played with, and now I understand why he would never answer that question, because it was like 2 pages long, and he's played with just about everybody and anybody, and it's crazy. When you get to our age, you know, all the people that you've worked with and the people that have passed through, you know, it's crazy when you think about it. But anyway, so we're moving on to the third song on your 5 song CD here, and tell us a little bit about that one.
Hey, before that, so I'd like to say thank you to the person who called in and won a free download of Unpopular Music for Popular People, Volume 1. Thank you very much. I appreciate you. And I think that's cool. Really happy to be able to participate in your endeavors, Joe.
Yes. Well, maybe we could put it up for the silent auction as well. We'll figure that out later. But anyway, okay, so the third song on the CD is called what?
Rule the World.
Ooh, I heard this one before. This is a good one. I like this one, Rule the World. Oh, you know not what I was going to add in?
I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was going to say, not a very unique title, but hey, everybody wants to rule the world, right?
Apparently, if you watch the news. You know, it's really funny, you were talking about something that inspired you to do that other song that you'd seen on TV. When I saw the interview with Ozzy and Geezer from Black Sabbath, they were on at the Grammy Museum. We got to go, Dave and I got to go check out Ozzy's interview, and it was so cool. It was right when Black Sabbath got back together and did that tour. Mm-hmm. But one of the questions that was asked to him, and I didn't know this, mostly Ozzy never hardly wrote anything, if anything at all. Geezer was the person behind all the lyrics and writing.
Really?
So they talked a little bit to, you know, and the guy asked Geezer where he got his inspiration from for his writing. And his reply was, I watch the 11 o'clock news. And I get my inspirations from that. What's going on in the world? It's just crazy.
Wow. How
so when you said that, it reminded me of when he made that comment, too. It's just
Well, me and Geezer will have to sit one down at one day at a pub, and I'll say, your head looks like a nib.
Yeah, maybe so. Anyway. Just crazy stuff, right? All right. So, anyway, back to the third song. This one's Rule the World. This one is by Dan Sindel. Here we go. Tuned into the Local Joe Show here on 97.3 107.9 The Rockin'. We are playing some of the brand new CD, 5-song EP from Dan Sindel, and that song was called Rule the World. Mr. Dan, wow, Yeah. I'm telling you, man, yeah, you got some rocking stuff going on there. I can't believe you sing great. That's cool.
Who would have known, huh?
Yeah, who would have known? All those years in a heavy metal band, I think you did a lot of backup vocals, but I don't remember.
No, I never touched the microphone at all.
You never did, huh?
I just played my guitar. I never thought I could sing.
Yeah, I guess Paul was the one that did most of the backup stuff, huh?
Yeah. I never
Stone Soldier days. Yeah.
I just wanted to play guitar. I didn't want to even try.
But. Yeah, I know. Well, that was the toughest part. I think that was probably one of the main things, was finding the proper singer for you guys would have really, really put you over that edge. But
yeah,
anyway.
Well, that was the problem for that band, which is why we missed the great wave of every band being signed in L.A. We lost our singer, and it took us over almost a year and a half, to finally get one where we got back out there, and everybody got signed, and we pretty much stood there watching everyone else have the fun.
Yeah, we did get to play with a whole bunch of great people back in the day, though. We played with just about every top 80s metal band, even still up to today. I mean, gosh, so many. Metal Church and all those Flotsam and Jetsam, and gosh, you guys played with a lot of great people. Bixen, wasn't it? Wow, just lots. What was that? King Diamond.
Remember
King Diamond?
Rex, yeah. Wendy Williams.
Exactly.
Oh, the list goes on and on.
On and on and on, yes. A lot of great names in the 80s metal still out there playing.
Yeah.
But anyway, baby. That was amazing. I really did enjoy that one. That is a good song. It's got a nice rockin' beat to it. I'm digging that one. All right, so what's up next? Number four.
Oh, well, I actually wanted to, since we were kind of going track by track, I wanted to talk to you a little about Real World, because I mean, we were talking about AI and studios and everything these days. You know, it's crazy because this song was recorded, well, the drums was recorded by my friend Rick Schlosser, and he's a little bit older now, older than us, and he is a studio guy that was an A-list guy in the 70s. He's played with everybody you can imagine. He's been on so many gold and platinum records with Van Morrison, and he's played with Alice Cooper and Cher and James Taylor. I mean, his career, he even played with Ringo Starr from the Beatles, and here he is playing with me on my music. It's just crazy.
Wow.
And Rick, he doesn't live in the country anymore. He's in Mexico. So I was able, through all this modern technology, to send him my tracks through the internet, and he has a studio in Mexico where he recorded, and they were able to send it back to me. And then I have the music mixed here back home by my good friend John Perpich. There's your shout-out, Johnny. Thank you for everything, buddy. Without this, my friend John Perpich, without him, this album wouldn't even exist. He's a lifesaver. He's an engineer who's just amazing. Thank you, bro. Anyways, I'm babbling, but
no, good shout-out. Well-deserved.
Yeah, Johnny, love you, man. And, you know, it's just amazing that you could have somebody in a whole different time zone in another country still work on your music and get it back to you through the internet. It's just so cool. And, you know, this project has been a great adventure for me.
Yeah.
So the next song is called Stepping Stone. And this is another love song, if you will.
Okay.
All my songs are love songs. Come on.
I love it. Go for it.
You crack me up. Puppy dogs to project love.
No, you do not. Puppies and kitties.
That's right.
All right.
If you ever read Mad magazines when we were kids, they would say, never mind.
Yeah. Well, you know what? I wanted to add in a little bit to what you were talking about, how amazing it is to, you know, there's so many pluses and minuses to AI anymore. You know, literally, I was having this conversation with Steve Mann, the guitarist from Michael, and he was talking about how much AI has come in and almost, you know, replaced musicians in certain places, and that you can almost pretty much have a show and not really even have anybody there. You could put in some parameters to the computer, it'll come up with a song, it writes the song, it does everything, it could play the song, and you don't even have to have any human people. Like, what, you know, he said, what are we coming to? Like, we're going to go to a show and there's not even a band there anymore? So, you know, there's a plus and a minus side to all this, but the blessing side is, you know, what you just shared is the ability to be able to do things with people that are all over the world. And as a matter of fact, since you were mentioning that, I had Images of Eden on 2 weeks ago, and they all live in different parts of the country. So they never get together for recording at all, ever. They all do their own parts. The singer is the main force in writing the original stuff, or, you know, I mean, just originally starting it with the vocals and some, you know, parameters that he sends out to everybody. But, you know, the one cool thing that I thought of was, while we were talking about it, is that when you get the idea, if you're not all together in the same room, like if you've watched some of the bigger bands, you know, go back to while they're in the studio and they're recording and they're doing their thing, and how they work off of each other and kind of, you know, give suggestions. But when you're on your own and you just get it and you just kind of do your own thing and then bring it back to the band, it seems like you're, you know, you are really truly putting out your own effort in that part that you play without any other influence. And then yet when, you know, they send it in, then they can give the feedback and all that kind of stuff. And then they just engineer it all back together, and it works. One of them does live in Mexico, in Juarez, and the rest are all spread out across the country, Arizona, Pennsylvania, you know, all over the place. And yet they just put all their parts, you know, send them out, do their parts, send them back, and they make, you know, music. And as a matter of fact, Bill Metoya was the one doing their engineering from Metallica.
Oh, Bill, right. Oh.
Yeah, and Metal Blade. So anyway, very similar, and that's the way, you know, it seems like that's the way we're going in the direction we're moving in this, with all these abilities.
Well, nothing can replace the thrill of live rock and roll.
Nothing ever will.
And you guys up there in Central Coast, Morro Bay, Pismo, I plan on getting up there. I promise you. Hopefully sometime within the next few months that I'll be able to come up and play some music for you guys.
Yeah, maybe we could put together a show for you here in the town. Siren would probably be a good one for that. We'll see.
Yeah.
I'll look into it.
AI,
for you. Yeah.
I'll use my automated robot.
Yeah, we'll just put a cutout, cardboard cutout of you on stage. This guy is so amazing. Look at he doesn't even look like he's playing guitar. Oh, Dan, that's too much fun. All right, so we digressed here a little bit. Fourth song. I'm getting close to my top of the hour here.
Better hurry up.
Yeah, well, it's okay. How long is this song?
Stepping Stone is a four-minute love song.
Four-minute love song. I love it. So, and that's number four, right? Stepping Stone?
And this features my good friend, once again, John Ayala on drums. Here's your second shout-out, Johnny.
he's a rock star now. He's been mentioned on the radio twice. It's crazy. I love
it. I'm telling you.
I know. They're good people. I know who you're talking about. All right, so you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and do my top of the hour, and then we're going to go right into your song, okay?
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
The Rock Community Radio, 97.3, 107.9, The Rock. Listener-supported community radio, KEBF, Morro Bay, KZSR, Paso Robles. We are streaming worldwide at therockcommunityradio.org, or you can take us wherever you go with our free iPhone and Android app. Search for The Rock Community Radio in the App Store or on Google Play. Ask Alexa to launch The Rock Community Radio, or you can email us at yourvoice@therockcommunityradio.org, or you can call us directly here in the studio at 805-772-2037. Yeah. You are tuned in to the Local Joe Show, where we are feeling the love with some love songs by Dan Sindel. Oh, Dan, we gotta love it. A love song.
Love comes in
many different forms. It does. Fun stuff. Wow. That one's really got an uptone beat to it. I really like that one. That's amazing. You've got to be so proud. This is just crazy that you've done all of the stuff, basically, except for the drums on all of these. This is really, really cool. So what would you like to tell us about Stepping Stone? Anything else about that song?
Stepping Stone. Oh,
that was John Iola on the drums on this one?
Yeah. That was Johnny.
Okay.
Well, I'll tell you what. It was like poetry in motion, man. You know, John showed up into the studio. We practiced maybe once. I drove out to his house to work on it just a little bit pre-production before we went into the studio. All right, we sifted through a couple ideas, whatever. When he got into the studio, he sat down and he just knocked that out with one try. Just boom, done. 4 minutes later, thank you. It was just like, me and John Perpich, who was recording, we were in the control room just looking at each other like, what? Oh, my God. I mean, flawless, no mistakes. It was just like, wow. It was a beautiful thing to watch. And he did the same thing with All Due Respect, the first song we played.
Mm-hmm.
He came in, he did those on one take. Didn't have to stop it, didn't have to punch him in. It was just like, if that was the World Series, he hit 2 Grand Slam freaking home runs.
Wow. That is amazing. That is amazing. Studio time is so expensive. It's nice when they just knock it out and get it done, right?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
But besides that, just to watch somebody just come in and just like so effortlessly handle the jobs, like you don't see that very much, you know?
Right. Yeah, no, you don't. You definitely gathered some caliber people to help you out with this project. It's amazing.
Yeah. Very fortunate to have some of the guys that helped me step up to the plate and, you know, just the way things were and availability and just, you know, the stars just aligning at the right time. It took me about 3 years to get this far with just 5 songs finished. I still have 6 songs in the can, so Volume 2 of this project.
Ooh.
Popular Music for Popular People, Volume 2, should be done sometime by next year.
Oh, nice. All right, so we have something to look forward to.
Yeah, I have 6 more of these songs, and they're all different drummers, and just every kind of genre and feel and groove and texture I've tried to incorporate. So, you know, as far as what type of music am I really playing? I have no clue. It's just really a little bit of everything.
Yeah, it really is. It's a nice collection of different sounds. Fun stuff.
No,
you know what?
A couple friends.
How
do you classify this?
Yeah.
You know, I talked to one friend, said, well, maybe power pop? And I thought, well, not really. How about melodic hard rock? Okay.
Oh.
Well, maybe a little, but not really.
Wow.
I don't know.
Well, you know what? It covers, it's across the board. That's the best way to put it. It's across the board. I like that one.
Yeah.
It kind of hits on a lot of different stuff. So, you know, it widens your demographics of people that are going to listen to it. So I like it. It's good stuff.
Well, it probably showcases my extreme case of attention deficit. I get bored really quickly staying in the same little area in music. I like to explore.
Right.
I like to create, and I just don't like to sit around doing the same thing for very long. So, you know, everything always has to kind of evolve and sort of mutate into something else instead of just sticking with the same thing. So yeah, I'm just a creative guy, and this is a outburst of my crazy personality.
Well, it's well done and super amazing. So tell us about the fifth song that you have on this one. What's this one called?
This is the very last song, folks, and thank you for hanging in there this far. This last song, number five, is called Edge of Eternity.
Ooh.
And this one features my beautiful friend, God rest his soul, Alex Wyatt, once again. And in all of my songs that I've recorded, this to me really means a lot to me because it's probably got, you know, as far as depth is concerned, to me, this one has the most depth to it. It's my sort of personal Bohemian Rhapsody, Stairway to Heaven type of composition. It, well, you'll hear it, but I think it is really cool. It just covers a lot of ground, and to me, it's meaningful. What can I tell you? You know, beauty's in the eye of the beholder.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, since we're listening to music, beauty is in the ear of the beholder. Huh? There you go.
I like that. All right. Well, we are going to go ahead and play your song. And when we come back, we'll talk a little bit more about it as well. You know what? Before we go real quick, though, I wanted to say, this week the Rolling Stones just released their a new album. I don't know if you've got a chance to hear any of it yet. We are going to play it. We are going to play it on the show after we finish with all of your beautiful music. But I was listening to it last night a little bit before, and, they released it just like you did, kind of, you know, there was a few songs that were released, and then now the whole album's out. And if you go through that album, there are so many different genre changes, or I don't know how you would even classify what they've done. It's so many songs are so different on the whole album, and if you stick around to listen to it today, you'll see what I'm talking about, or look it up yourself. But so many songs. I don't know how you would even, and a lot of it goes back to the serious, the old time blues that came right out of Memphis, right out of the cotton fields kind of stuff, you know. Keith Richards is really into that old, you know, the old blues, and you could really see that influence in this album. So anyway,
that's where they started when they were kids.
Yeah, I mean, so I don't know if genre is so important anymore, Dan. It's nice to have a little versatility and kind of be a little bit all over the place, which is good.
I believe all boundaries have been, for the most part, been eliminated. I mean, granted, when the record stores were still a reality, they had the bins, and you sort of had to create a product that would fit in pop or rock or metal or jazz or something to that nature. But there was always, what would they call it, eclectic music off to the side or something where they didn't know what to call it. Then they called it alternative. Okay. What is it the alternative to? And if it's alternative, what's the alternative to alternative?
Very, very true.
So
wait a second. They used to have stores that sold records? What?
Wait, what's a record?
Are you kidding? Oh, my God, that's so amazing. You know what? That brings me back
just
to...
like your list of arrests that you've had.
Yeah. Tower Records downtown. They had a big one on Sunset Boulevard there, remember? That's funny.
Those are
of the past, for sure. Well, you know what? Not really. I mean, there are a lot of small stores that are still featuring, you know, LPs and albums and vinyl, you know. It's so big. It's actually come back, which is kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's a dream come true for me. I actually called a record manufacturer last week and discussed how to put an album together. What does it take? What are the costs? You know, they told me at around 500 albums, I could probably get an album made for about $5-6 on my own with a four-color jacket and the whole thing. So, you know, sometime next year, if I'm bold and brave enough, I just may go ahead and self-produce some vinyl. It's always been a dream of mine.
Wow. Yeah, that would be really cool, actually. Well, when you do that, I definitely want one of those.
Well, there you go. Hey, if anyone in radio land is listening right now and you're an actual label or distributor, contact me and let's talk shop, huh?
Yeah.
Let's get this music out there, baby.
Sounds good to me, Dan. Sounds good to me. All right. So, song number five. We're back. Boy, did we digress on that one. All right. Anyway, I get this way talking to you, Dan. It's so crazy. I have all these lovely questions, but I always go right out the window with them when we're talking with you. I just know you too well.
Oh, yeah?
I don't
what
know.
Question you got?
Oh, no. I just, you know, the normal. I have a really good list of interview questions, actually. So, but that's not for today. Today we're just putting out your EP and telling everybody about all your new music. So it's good stuff. All right. So song number five, what's it called?
This is Edge of Eternity.
All right. Edge of Eternity by Dan Sindel. Here we go. We'll be right back. are tuned into 97.3, 107.9 The Rock and the Local Joe Show. Dan, wow, that is amazing. So this this was featuring Alex on drums?
Yes.
Wow.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's amazing. Wow. His family's got to be really proud. It's amazing that there is a legacy that left behind. You know, it's very sad he passed, especially so early. He was very young. He was in his 30s, wasn't he?
34, yeah.
Yeah, that's way too early. Wow, geez. Well,
yeah, so I truly dedicate this album to his spirit.
Yes, and silence was, silence after that was amazing for him. Yeah, that's rough. I know, Dan. But at least, you know, now, you know, like you said, you've captured his spirit in the song, and it's amazing. So you did a great job on this whole album. I can't say enough. This is amazing that you put it all together and played most of the instruments, except for the drums, obviously, on all of this, and including the vocals, which is really cool, because it seems like that was kind of a step out of your box in a way, saying, you know, you've really never sung before, which is kind of cool. But I wanted to tell you that we have a ton of blue dots across the country and across the world on my monitor screen. So you truly are worldwide now, Dan.
Well, hello, world. I sure hope you like the music.
Yes, we got quite a few blue dots there. And one of them, one of them is actually another streaming station that streams us throughout the rest of the world, too. It's pretty cool. So
nice.
lots of people out there listening in to Dan Sindel's debut of his brand new five-song CD there. EP, you would call it? EP?
Yes.
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 All right, well.
Popular music for popular people. Volume 1, folks.
Well, you may have to change that to popular music one of these days, because I think you're going to get quite a bit of hits on this one. Did you put it on Spotify already or any of the social medias?
Three songs at the moment are on YouTube with animated videos and on Spotify. Rule of the World, Stepping Stone, and Edge of Eternity have already been released. All due respect and Say Goodbye have actually been world premiered here today on the Morning Local Joe Show.
Wow, man, I feel so...
97.3, hurrah!
I feel so privileged. That's amazing. Wait a second. I'm glad I asked that question. Let's back up a little bit here. With animated videos, so you did the animation on the videos too?
Yeah, I also love drawing cartoons doing animation. And I kind of have been, over the few past 5 years or so, been teaching myself how to do computer animation. I'm not great, but I have fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I made all kinds of cool robots and weird space backgrounds and just kind of put them in instead of just showing another guy with his guitar singing, whatever.
Right.
But yeah. So, yeah, my videos so far have been animated by me as well. The whole thing has really been a solo project, so to speak.
Yeah, so many different creativity, creativeness there. You're amazing. I can't. And we got to tell the listeners that you now have chosen a little bit of your artwork for some guitar picks.
That's right. Yeah. I draw cartoons all day long and. Yeah, I mean, you can put anything on a T-shirt or a mug or a hat or a towel or anything these days, and now you can print your own guitar picks as well. So
yeah,
yeah, I put a couple funny of my little creatures on some guitar picks, and I feature some of my artwork. If you ever get a chance to download a digital copy of my project here, I put together a little ebook with lyrics and kind of pepper the whole thing with a bunch of my cartoons as well.
Oh, neat. All right. Well, I can't wait to see that. I have to have mentioned you just built a guitar. That was really cool. I saw the painting you did on that guitar. It was amazing.
Oh, yeah. The monster guitar.
The monster. Yeah. That one seemed like it came out. How does it play?
it plays really nice. And I really, there's a few shout outs there. I have a company that endorsed me. They're called Sophia Tremolos. And these guys are amazing. John and Jeff, these guys, if you're a guitar player or know anything about guitars, these guys make whammy bars. And they're the most cutting edge and just most advanced whammy bar system out there now. They're kind of a smaller company. They're not on every guitar that you see at the Guitar Center or whatever, like a Floyd Rose or whatever company. Mm-hmm. But they're up and coming. They got some big names already on board, and they put together the guitar for me the other day. They helped put a new neck on the guitar for me and got it playing really nice. I'm so happy. I'm so grateful for these guys.
Wow, that sounds really amazing. So they were able to help you put the rest of it. So it's a whammy bar? I think I saw something about it. Stays in tune really good. The whammy bar? Dan? Did I lose you? Uh-oh. I think we lost Dan. Where did Dan go? Okay. Anyway, maybe we'll hang up. He'll have to call back. I don't know what happened there. That's pretty funny. Okay. So anyway, wow, that was super amazing. So Dan Sindel, like you said, we've been friends since high school. I actually used to take guitar lessons from him back in the day. And unfortunately, I couldn't sit still long enough to practice all the time. So I was a big skateboarder and surfer. So I would rather be out playing around in the water or in the skate parks back in the day. But yeah, we've known each other for over 40-some years. It's really kind of crazy. I used to do road crew work for them in their metal band, Stone Soldier, back in the day. And we did quite a few shows in Southern California, and they made it pretty big for quite a while there. And if you were listening to any of the show, we played with the who's who of all the heavy metal back in the 80s. So it's really neat to still have our friendship together still to this day. And I wanted to mention, we were just talking, since we lost him, we were just talking about his creative side doing this artwork stuff. And I just want to give a little mention to for George Lindsay Jr. I know George, who has recently passed as well, was a huge, huge influence on Dan in inspiring him to start drawing and doing his creative artwork that he's been doing. So it's really neat to see it come this far, and I think it's a great tribute to George to at least mention that I think he gave Dan the push he needed to get going on that. And look at where it is now. Guitar picks and guitars and all kinds of other fun stuff. So anyway, Dan Sindel, super talented, super amazing. What a great guy. And can't say much more. So too bad we lost him. Oh, wait, he's calling back. Here he is. Hold on. Danny, hold on. Okay, Dan, you there?
Yeah, sorry about that, folks.
No, that's okay. I was just bragging about you.
Oh, man.
I was just telling the story of how long we have known each other. And you know what? I wanted to say this while you're here, because I don't know if you were listening while you were off the phone. But
no, I was trying to get my phone back online. I apologize, everybody.
No worries. So I was mentioning the fact that unfortunately George Lindsay Jr. just passed, and we were all very good friends. And I know George shared with me quite a few times how much of an influence he was to get you to start drawing and doing the artwork and the little robots and things that you were doing. And he was so proud of you for pushing on and doing that. And so I was just mentioning that, you know, look where you've come with your artwork to this day, and how neat it was that he gave you that artistic push. So if that's all true. Yes, exactly. Ah, George. Yeah, we miss him. He's too much. But
I'm looking at a little shrine of him right now on my computer console in my studio.
Yeah,
I have his CD right in front of me, where he's dressed up as kind of a goober cowboy.
Yeah, Yes. Well,
he's with me, man.
I know. He is. He's looking down on us. It's fun. I guess we could share one more thing real quickly. It was really kind of funny, but you know, George used to do those pony shows. You know, he'd ride around and tell stupid jokes at the county fairs, you know. And he had these fake little horses that he'd made up out of barrels and horsehair, and you know, these little things really looked pretty real, like they were real ponies. You know, I mean, a lot of kids that came up to us weren't too sure if they were real or not. It was really kind of funny. But one of the weekends, one of his shows, his guy got sick, and they were contracted. So out of the blue, he called me up and said, "I don't know. This is maybe sound crazy to you, but you're the only one I think's crazy enough to maybe say yes. So, would you know, you'd be interested in doing a weekend with me in the horsey show? I'll send you some jokes." And so he sent me the jokes, and we did the thing, and we rode around on ponies for the whole weekend at this horse fair, telling really dumb cowboy jokes. It was really, and horsey jokes, you know.
Oh, that's funny. Let's hear a joke.
So, what's a horse's favorite hairdo? A ponytail. Anyway, we used to tell some really dumb jokes, but yeah, George inspired.
What's a cow's favorite thing to do?
Moo. I don't know.
Go to the movies.
Anyway, I just had to give a quick shout out to George. He influenced all of us to be where we are at today in some way or another. So, anyway, you know, Dan, I don't know how much more creative or artistic you could possibly get. I know most of your training was classical, right, as a kid?
Classical, jazz, orchestra, sure.
Yeah. Did you start playing guitar or piano?
No, I started playing the trumpet when I was 9 years
wow.
old.
Wow. Now that's amazing.
I was a troubled little kid waking up my neighbors at 6 in the morning playing taps and reveille. Boy, they hated me.
Oh, I bet. It's like the rooster in the yard, right? Well, it's kind of funny. Nancy was mentioning that she was playing violin as a child. And unfortunately, she couldn't practice enough because, you know, her parents said it sounded like she was killing cats. So
right.
You got to stop. But I'm not going to get any better if I don't practice. It's, I can only imagine what her neighbors were thinking, too. Huh? Anyway. Well, Dan, it's been amazing getting to talk to you again this morning. We're having a great time. This is amazing music. I hope everybody looks it up. And that's why I was asking about it being on Spotify and stuff. And it's kind of neat. Some of that's kind of neat because then you can see how many people are looking at it and all that kind of fun stuff. And kind of gives you an idea. So if you are so inclined, look up Dan Sindel and his new 5-song EP. Was there anything else you'd like to share or any shout outs before we have you on the show next time?
I don't know what to say, but I mean, truly, I'm grateful that you have me on and premiering my new album. To me, this is a huge thrill. And, you know, I've said it a couple times in the course of our hour, but I'm grateful for your listeners. I really hope you guys enjoyed the music. And, yeah, what more can I say?
Well, Dan, we look
grateful
for
the whole experience here.
Well, me too. We look for much, much more to come from you in many different realms, in videos and in music. So go on and check out his animated videos if you can. And send a shout-out Dan's way. Let him know he's doing a great job. So thank you very much, Dan. It was a pleasure to have you on this morning.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Nancy. Thank you, 97.3 The Rock.
You got it. So we'll see you up here sometime soon, Dan. Thank you, buddy.
Yeah, looking forward. I'll see you guys sometime, maybe at the end of the year or early next year.
Yeah, let me know when you kind of got something together. We could try to see if we can put together a show for you at one of the places up here.
That'd be really awesome. Cool.
Yeah.
That would be great.
All right, Danny boy. Well, we're going to move on. So if you want, keep the computer on. We're going to play that new Rolling Stones album for you.
I will.
There you go.
Thank you, everybody. Have a great day.
All right. All right, Dan Sindel, everybody. Thank you.
Bye.
All right, here we go. All right, well, now we're back. 97.3, 107.9, The Rock.